Even though ITEC was officially founded in Central Florida in 1996, the idea first came to life in the same place where five young missionaries were killed deep in the Amazon. God began writing this story almost 70 years ago when he called my dad, Nate Saint, along with Jim Elliot, Ed McCulley, Roger Udarian, and Pete Fleming, all recently married and starting families, to take the gospel to unreached tribes in the Ecuadorian jungle. The Waodani were people characterized by violence. As the industries of the modern age clashed with the Stone Age peoples inhabiting the jungle, attacks on settlements were not uncommon. This violence was also common within the tribe, who were formerly known to the local Quechuas as Aucas, or savages. With a homicide rate of nearly 60%, many in the Waodani tribe did not live to even the age of 30. In late 1955, the five missionaries began regular flights over Waodani territory, becoming the first Westerners to establish peaceful contact with this tribe. After months of exchanging gifts with the Waodani, all five missionaries, including my dad, were killed at the end of Waodani spears. The event, which occurred on that small beach in the rainforests of Ecuador, has become one of the most widely known acts of martyrdom in the last century.
That out of this apparent tragedy is coming a wonderful note of victory. To try to evaluate what these men have done in human terms is indeed difficult. To think of this martyrdom of five valiant men on a material basis is indeed absurd. It is on the high spiritual elevation of love of Christ and of his gospel, more than the love of self.
To most people, the death of my dad, my hero, would seem to be a tragic end to the story. But God was only just beginning to write a story that would display boldness, sacrifice, and gospel transformation. The sacrifice and efforts of these five men laid a foundation which allowed Elisabeth Elliot, the wife of Jim Elliot, and my Aunt Rachel to live with the tribe. Through their work, a number of the tribe began to walk God's trail, leaving behind their violent ways and celebrating their new life following Wangungi's trail. The tribe became family, and Minkai, one of the men who speared my dad, adopted me as one of his own. Years later, two of the other men whose spears killed my dad baptized me in the same river where he died. Only God could write this story of relentless love and redemption. After Aunt Rachel died, the Gikitedi clan of Waodani asked that we move to the Ecuadorian jungle to live with them. During my time amongst the tribe, I wondered what I could do for them that Western missionaries were not already doing. The Waodani told me, "We don't want you to come do for us. We want you to teach us how to do the things that the outsiders have been doing for us." They ultimately wanted to meet the needs of their own tribe and then to use those skills to reach their own people with the gospel. I realized that the command of the Great Commission in Matthew 28 was given to all believers, including the Waodani believers. Amazingly, the Waodani who killed Dad and his four friends in 1956 laid the blueprint for ITEC that we still use today. Since the mid-1990s, God has faithfully provided ITEC a growing team and facility dedicated to inspire Great Commission participation of all believers. Today, the ITEC team develops tools and training systems, trains Christ followers around the world, and equips others to do the same, both domestically and abroad. We do this with the belief that God has uniquely equipped all believers to participate in the Great Commission.